Shall I set the scene for you?
Oh, please.
I'm feeling like this is maybe 1990, possibly 1991, yeah?
Love
so it. Little Goods, mini Goods.
Mini Goods.
Before the beers. Still a little wanker, but I was little at the time. My mum, single mum, working hard for us, me and my sisters and that. She invested at the time in something called a VCR. It's quite a rare thing on our street. Not many people had VCRs. So my sisters, who are older than me, very proud of it. And then they retell the story, one of my earliest memories, of me walking up to that VCR for no good reason and then pissing in the flap of the VCR.
Oh, no. I suppose it's early streaming technology, isn't it? After that, though?
No, there was steam coming out, like smoke coming out. The one thing I do remember is, like, obviously pissing in the flap, yeah, and it was turned on and it's sparking.
Wow.
So, one of the first memories I have of the magic that my can do, yeah. Yo, it causes sparks and electricity.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Even at that young age, it's the first time I was ever kicked in the chest.
By your mum?
Yeah, by my mum. She came out of nowhere. Kick in the chest. The footprint was on my chest for quite a long time. And some of you might be thinking, that's harsh to kick like a 5-6-year-old in the chest. I never pissed in that VCR again. Never, ever. When I was at school, I used to get in trouble quite a bit. Not always because it was my fault. There was one notorious teacher that just kept mugging me off. And I won't say his name for legal purposes, but he stunk off piss, bro. You know, like, you get them teachers and they come in and don't give a shit. They're like, oh, make sure you're hygienic. And he smelt like a skip. With shit and dicks in it. It was horrible. He just stopped. So I was convinced that he wasn't doing a very good job.
Right.
And to prove it, he set us quite a hefty coursework assignment. And I said to the man, I was like, yo, I bet you he doesn't even check it. I'm going to prove it to you. I did the first 3 pages of the coursework and I took an A4 ream of paper and I just put the first 3 pages on top. And on the 4th page, I wrote, I owe you. And I submitted it. The whole first term's gone past. I'm like, sir, what's my coursework saying? He's like, yeah, really good. I was like, told you. Told you. He's not checking the work. And so it comes to the last few weeks of A-levels.
Yeah.
Time to submit all this work. What happened is he had a spot check and they found out that even though he said that my coursework was an A grade, it only had 3 pieces of paper in it and an IOU. And then he got called into the head teacher's office with me. But the terrible thing is my mum was also sat there as well.
Oh.
And this was about the 37th time that she kicked me in the chest. So in front of all the teachers. So I might have to say sorry to him because he did almost get sacked.
Wow. So what grade did you get?
Because he lied, they had to give me an auto pass, which was a C, but I think that's pretty good for not doing fuck all, to be honest.
Because that's really good.
I never read past page 3 because I get distracted by the titties.
Louis, got any more props for us?
Well, this one's, you wouldn't believe it, it's a fucking pigeon.
It's a pigeon. Anyone claiming the pigeon?
I was about 19. Used to work at this place, Phones For You, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Christmas time, retail. Everyone who works when they're young and they're in retail, you're just mucking about, ain't you?
Yeah.
You're just messing around. So we closed up the shop early, which we weren't supposed to do, and we decided to play football on the top floor, which is where we kept all the phones. And Cov City Centre, the building was on the corner, massive bit of glass. And so everyone's having a penalty shootout. I was in goal. And I still remember Ali clapped the ball. I was not quick enough to stop it and it smashed the window, like, quite high up. And all we heard as the glass shattered quite quickly afterwards was screams from, like, pensioners on the ground. Like,
ah, fucking glasses hit me visor.
All this, yeah? We've shit ourselves now. And they're all like, good, you prick. The only thing you had to do was save the ball. I was like, you kicked it 400 miles an hour. That's not my fault, is it? So the glass is shattered and our store manager, who told us she had left, was doing shopping at Boots. She was buying shit presents. She was at Boots. She's come back. She said, what happened? How has this happened? Whose fault is this? And the first thing we could think of is, oh, pigeon flew. Pigeon. Pigeon, big pigeon flew. And she's like, where? I say, I don't know. It's the big pigeon I ever seen. It's like a dog. Just flew, bang, in the window. All the glass went everywhere.
Good. Good.
Did she believe it?
I don't care.
It's what have we hair got? Removal cream.
Does this chime with anyone?
No, what are you looking at me for?
Because
I'm going to get banged in the head if my sister sees this. So,
Uh-oh.
My sister was a teenager, and that's a very difficult time for boys and girls and all combinations, and she was very self-conscious of her upper lip because her upper lip was coming with one hench moustache, like uncles would see in the street and say, that is fantastic. Like, they were not... She was killing it. But someone told her that if she shaved it, I don't know, it was a myth, if you shave it, it comes back twice as thick.
It does.
Yeah, but I remember thinking, if it comes back twice as thick as that, you're going to block the sun. It was thick, it was... oh, it was thick, man. My cousin, he played a prank on his sister a few months earlier, and he'd put a dye in this cream that she used on the moustache. So I did the same thing because I'm that piss in the video kid, yeah? So so I put it in and she put the cream on, and then, like, 2 hours later, her upper lip was blonde. So she had this hench blonde moustache. Like, bless her, because she had to go to school with either the fear of, like, this mad blonde moustache or shave it and it come back like a bush. So she just braved the blonde moustache for about 6 weeks.
Oh. That's a wrong one right there.
Well,
and a teenage girl with a big blonde tash, that's unforgivable. Who have we got?
It's a human pop.
It is Mark Silcox. Now, who among this bunch of rotten tearaways has an apology for Mark here?
Not me.
Do you want to tell us all about it, Gus?
Mark is an incredibly funny man, and as a result, we wanted him to come and be part of this silly show that we made. A lot of people liked it, and Mark became an icon, especially in the streets. And I'm not sure Mark was prepared to be an icon in the streets where he became the icon. what I didn't know at the time is that Mark was also still a fully functioning teacher. And so Mark would come to set, and because Mark's such a bad man, he didn't give a shit about scripts. He'd turn up and he'd say, what am I doing today? And we'd be like, don't worry, here's what you got to do. So we'd start filming, and then we'd throw things in for Mark to say.
Brilliant.
And Mark would say all of them, no question, because he trusted me like some kind of dickhead nephew. He trusted me. So we were on set and Mark was there firing off lines like, you are a pum-pum, you are a pussy hole, you are a pussy liquor, you are a pum-pum liquor. And it turns out that Mark didn't know what any of these words meant. So when he would go to school and all of the kids would be like, yo, sir, is that you mashing a pum-pum, yeah? Things became quite difficult for Mark, so I would like to apologise for that, Mark, boy, and I love you very dearly.
Oh, that's excellent. Oh.
Mark, if you don't know what that stuff means, why are you texting me on the regular?
So, Mr. Silcox, do you still teach?
I do teach, yeah.
You do? You still teach?
I was about to give up my job because I couldn't cope. All the abuse I was getting.
Yeah, but Mark, you shagged a couple of single moms, innit? I know it. I know it. Mark's the man, a mad one. Mark said, I will show you the pum pum. Come on, come with me. Come on.
I don't even know what pum pum is. What is pum pum?
Mark, I believe, fully could kick the shit out of me, so I don't want to take this too much further than it is. Like, yeah. I don't want to get knocked out on TV by Mark Silcox.
It's the clenched fist.
It's the clenched fist. Yeah. It's the right clenched fist. Mark Silcox, ladies and gentlemen. Yes.